You guys got your work cut out for you for the next day or so?
Yep. Okay. It's going to take a while. These are
Chris Davis is an elections administrator. He's in charge of ballot processing and vote counting on election day. The voting forms are held in these boxes.
They're locked and they're sealed with serial number seals on them, and we record that.
Chris has worked four elections in his current role, but this is the first time he's seen so many early votes in his county. More than 200,000 people have already cast their ballot, more than the total number of votes in 2016.
We've seen more folks vote in person for this election than we ever have for any other election. Could be that these may be the same people that vote and that we're going to vote on election day but decided to do it earlier. And perhaps on election day it'll be very slow around all the polling places. But we think it's more of the other case of there's just more folks that want to vote. There's more passion in the presidential election than I think any other kind of election in this county, in this state, and probably in the country.
Traditionally, Williamson County votes Republican like the rest of Texas. But voter turnout is usually low in this state of 29 million people, the largest in the country.
Make sure your cell phone is off and are on silent. Put away. Make sure you have a photo ID. You're going to go down this hall.
19 polling stations are open to voters in the county, but cameras aren't allowed inside the buildings.
Usually I wait till election day to vote, but this time it's pretty important to get out and vote. And if Trump has done anything, he's motivated people to get out and vote this time. Do their civic duty and make sure this country is heading in the right direction.
Texans don't register by party, making it difficult to say who is leading in early voting. If the Democrats win Texas, which hasn't happened since 1976, it would end any chance of Donald Trump's re-election.